This is Terry Kurtz Online, reporting on Victor Valley, High Desert, and Mojave River Valley events, activities, entertainment, sports, and history. Opening this week's edition of Terry Kurtz Online, Victor Valley TV education, news reports, and flashbacks.
Sure wish they had that make every day pay attendance program when we were in school.
Yeah, then we wouldn't be having to rob banks for a living.
15 students from High Desert High Schools have received scholarships awarded by the San Bernardino County First District State of Education Program. Recipients of $500 scholarships are Samantha Grantham of Granite Hills, Caitlin Hatcher of AAE, the Academy for Academic Excellence, and Ashley Mello of Oak Hills High School. High Desert School's educational success highlights over the past year include the Oak Hills High School mock trial team winning the county championship a second year in succession. The Oak Hills mock trial team ranked 11th in the state in 2023. The Lewis Center Academy for Academic Excellence was honored for its Space Force Junior ROTC and GAVRT astronomy partnership with NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. Excelsior High School was praised for its STEM and digital learning program. Its cybersecurity pathway offers students in-demand training on computer technologies, server and network security, cybersecurity and threat analysis. Hellendale's Excel Academy Charter School received this year's Distinguished School Award. Sitting Bull Academy is the only school in California designated a state school of character.
Well, some of the ways that the character has been built among the students is that we have many activities and we get to interact a lot with each other. The staff is really kind.
And one of the things I think made it rank so high is we do all kinds of different assemblies about it. And they follow up with the assemblies afterwards.
I think some things that go on at Sitting Bull Academy for the character award are just group activities that boost morale, and there are also, we have an amazing principal who thinks that character is the number one priority.
The emphasis on character has long been a priority. This interview from 2012.
We kind of adopted more than one character education program to kind of make it our own. We started off, I had the teachers trained in character counts.
Well, we have lots of assemblies of people coming out from different places of the country and talking to us about citizenship and respect and fairness and caring.
We have a thing that just happened. It's called the Breaking Down Assembly, and it helped us learn new things, and like it helped us get to know each other, and it taught us how to be like have good character.
Every morning for the first 25 minutes of the day, we have what we call an advisory period, and it's 25 minutes where we have our broadcast class gives a broadcast, but also we do a character education type activity.
It's like there was one week where they had a kindness week, and we got a paper, and there were a bunch of challenges that we could do on it, and we got to check one thing off after every time we did it. So like make a new friend, or compliment five people, or write a nice teacher to a note. Like there were lots of different things we could do, and throughout the week.
There's many friends that kind of raise you up, and like helps you to get your goal. They like, even though they don't always say it like that, but you could tell in their heart, like they're trying to mean that you're gonna be smart and you're gonna be a great person.
Well, we have like a lot of we have all of the electives and all like a lot of sports that are available for us.
I think we have a lot of leadership assemblies and character assemblies, and it like inspires people to.
The kindness challenge that we just did for National Kindness Week. How we have a whole bunch of school events to try and make the school cleaner, or have kids just get along with each other, be nice to each other.
Sitting Bull Academy was selected for meeting the criteria of consistently maintaining high morale, academic excellence in its student body, and low incidences of bullying.
One of our leaders here, one of the principals, since the principal, he actually every couple months or so, he'll have an assembly about bullying and what not to do, and stuff that's really personal that you shouldn't be sharing, your address with people you barely know, etc. And people from ASB, if they find someone alone, if they find someone hurt, will console them and talk to them.
Sometimes kids that have been bullied, the teachers will invite them to class and they could talk about it with them. The proctors, there's more proctors to prevent bullying. And we also have a caring week where people give out papers of I like your shoes and stuff.
She told us stories about her childhood and how she sort of bullied people. And it made us feel bad because we don't want to be like that. So it helped us know that we should treat others the way that we want to be treated.
We do a lot of current event type things. For instance, in the 7th grade science classes, the part of one of the topics that they have to go over are cells. And it used to be that they just would do they'd do a hands-on type thing with an animal and plant cell. And now I told them to try to get the character in. They actually did discussions and Socratic seminars on stem cell research and talking about the responsibility, the citizenship, and those types of any of the moral issues.
Sitting Bull Academy is one of only 65 schools in the nation awarded School of Character distinction.
I've noticed at Sitting Bull that no one's alone. There's nice people who will always just talk to someone. Everyone has a friend.
The reason why we were awarded the California Distinguished School was they called it signature practices that we had. And those signature practices actually helped our socioeconomically disadvantaged and our minority students actually make greater growth on our state tests. So it's called, closing the achievement gap. And those two signature practices, one of them is for our character education program. And we kind of adopted more than one character education program to kind of make it our own. We started off, I had the teachers trained in character counts, and that explained the six pillars of character. And it's kind of a common language that all the students have in eighth grade, the American history, trying to get some of the Constitution amendments, how they apply to their daily life. One of the things, if they want something changed in our handbook, that'd be do they have to make an amendment and come to me? And I told them I have veto power. So it was kind of cute, though, that they actually understood how government worked. The Distinguished School Committee said that they noticed how respectful the students were. When they came around, they said everybody was opening doors for them, yes ma'am, no sir, type thing. And then the other signature practice they said was our reading program, our reading rewards program. We use a district-adopted program, just the regular language arts program and the AR program, but what we have is we have a fairly extensive reward program for students making their individual goals. And then the other thing, we really try to get the kids involved. And that was one of the things the Distinguished School said, that they could tell our students are connected to the school. And so we try to have after-school activities. And our motto, our mantra, is something for everyone. Not everybody's an athlete. We have a lot of after-school sports type things. We have a ceramics class. We have book clubs for those. We do pentathlon. In fact, we host the High Desert Pentathlon here at our school, and we host the High Desert Leadership Conference here. Our tech lab, some of the boys that aren't athletes and they like to do things with their hands. And girls do it too, but we do have some of that. But our tech lab that uses, basically they're all professions, like manufacturers. They all lead to a career field. And so it's giving kids an opportunity to see what they might want to do in high school and college, or if they want to go to a tech type school after high school. So Same with music, and we want them to have everything. That's why we have lots of assemblies and different things, so that the kids understand, you know, don't want them to be just academic. We want them to have a, you know, have a taste of everything. Be well-rounded students.
That's not a good day because we're having ASVAB.
ASVAB? What is ASVAB? You're doing some kind of nuclear missile drills or something on that day? I don't know. What is ASVAB?
Sure wish they had that make every day pay attendance program when we were in school.
Yeah, then we wouldn't be having to rob banks for a living.
What are you gonna say? That good, huh? Very good, very good. How's everybody today?
Good, how are you?
Outstanding! Just like your attendance policy. Hello.
Hello.
I'd like to see Dr. Ryder, please. I am here to congratulate the school district on its attendance policy.
It's really helped ADA.
You have a district attorney?
This way, thank you.
Dr. Ryder, I presume.
Oh my word, it's the governor! Oh, I'm so excited. How are you, sir?
I am so pleased to meet you. I am here to congratulate you on your attendance stimulus package you have at the school district.
Cool. Oh, yes, but before we even talk about the stimulus package, can I get your autograph? This is such an honor.
Well, of course.
Oh, this is wonderful.
Should I just do it to the doctor?
Oh, yes. And just make it to the doctor and I can share it with all my colleagues. And they're so excited that you're here to support public education like you have in the past. This is such an honor.
There is another thing that really gives me a headache. Why can't the students have the cell phones on during class time?
Oh, my goodness. We have a new policy here. We're trying to get kids to focus on instruction and not texting.
As you know, I'm a family man. And what if there's a family emergency? Or more importantly, what if I have to text everybody to let them know that the Terminator is on the movie channel tonight?
Well, maybe some of those residuals from your movie could go to our Good to Great Fund for kids.
I concur. Consider this an endorse.
Hey, we'll meet you at the mine.
Who's mine? Nobody's.
My mine.
Whose mine is nobody's mine?
Geez, he should have stayed in school when he was a minor.
I never mind.
Never mind.
Well, Governor, I just want to say thank you for coming. We, as you know, we have a 1,000-day plan. We're going to move this district from good to great, and glad that you're here to be part of that.
1,000 days. That's 4 more years. That's 4 more years. I'll be back.
Did you send that email to Mr. Christopher's agent that he has been hired?
Yes, I still have the email. It's right here.
Oh no, not again. I'm fired.
Call his agent right away and let him know.
What? You mean I'm not fired? Great Scott! What? Now you want me to be there? When do you want me to be there? No! Great Scott! I don't have time for this. I have to wait till I get back. I'm the future!
And on the count of three, draw and fire. Got it?
Got it. I think so.
One!
I said on three!
Don't that fire one?
Serves him right for not finishing school.
That's right.
So why did my son get kicked out of this teacher's class?
Mr. Fuego, your son threw a book at Ms. Placid. Ms. Placid, could you please explain?
Didn't Wolfgang tell you he threw his textbook at me?
No, is that true?
Yeah.
Where did you ever get the idea that violence was okay?
Stop! Ms. Placid, call 911. Security, I need security down in admin. Lower admin, please, immediately.
Mañana, mañana, bananas, mañana.
It's about how Annie's trying to escape to find her parents, and on the way, she gets to find Mr. Warbucks.
Annie Jr., demonstrating Cobalt's outstanding talent in singing and theater.
Smile, Johnny, smile!
I did 5 push-ups for this, and I worked really hard.
We're having a blood drive on Monday.
It's just a shirt for the peer leaders so we can stand out and basically run this whole thing and we can know who's who.
Your first seminar.
Of excitement. They're going to see like little kids playing around, and most of them are trying to figure out who they really are.
When I come to Silverado, I feel safe, I'm ready to learn. One of the best qualities that I think Silverado has to offer is its diversity. So many different types of students who attend Silverado are able to teach the students who do attend Silverado. We have a lot of foreign exchange students, which I do believe is a very benevolent situation. One of the other great things, by the way, is our sports program. We have very dedicated coaching staff, very dedicated sports trainers who take care of the injured athletes. I think a sport that is able to be an outlet for a student is very important. And at Silverado, we take our sports very seriously. So being able to go somewhere where you do have a passion for as an escape is just as good as being an academic student who escapes from their books.
One of the things that I think is great about the school is that our staff is always interested in how to bring things to life. Today, for example, we have our Living History Days. We've had a farrier show up. We use probability in an old-time gambling hall. We do some of the old slave cabins. So the kids can kind of tie an event to a content standard. And that's a hard thing to do with kids, especially at the junior high level.
First thing one notices about this program, everything is positive. It stems from STEAM, science, technology, engineering, art, mathematics. The program, Millionaire Mind Kids, the brainchild of Victor Valley resident Dolores Williams.
Millionaire Mind Kids is a nonprofit organization, and we held the very first science, technology, engineering, and the arts, which is STEAM, and math summer camps in the high desert last summer, and out of that we formed some robotic teams that we were able to compete with at Legoland and with U.S. First.
Williams, who founded Millionaire Mind Kids in 2005, left a high position in the aeronautics industry to foster her grandchildren. The first commitment that evolved from first being a financial literacy program for at-risk students into today's highly successful and equally highly acclaimed launching pad for Millionaire Mind Kids.
We were asked by Victor Valley Union High School District to start robotic clubs in the school district. So kids are learning how robotic applications apply to aviation, aerospace, and all the various different careers. They are learning critical skills, thinking, program management, how to develop timelines, the entire planning process, life skills in terms of learning word applications and all the different programming applications.
A lot of the kids that are actually in the robotics are some of our at-risk kids, kids that are D's and F's in a lot of subjects, and then all of a sudden they get excited to do something like robotics.
My grades really haven't been all that well since before I became involved with Million Dollar Mind Kids. My grade point average was probably what? 1.8, 1.0, and now it's almost a 3.0, it's a 2.888 right now as we speak, so it actually helped me a lot.
I would love to have this robotics class next year in our master schedule, not after school, but during the regular school.
Being a group leader involves helping the others and teaching them in the robotics class how to program and how to build your own robot from scratch.
Robotics will never fail.
And what grade level are you?
I'm in 8th grade.
You're 8th grade?
Yes, and the program goes from 7th to 9th grade. And then also at the school, we have another program called MESA. And MESA also does the same sort of thing with the robots. It's more advanced, and it's actually pretty cool. And these over here are core values for our team. The first one, I think, is the most important, but it's we have fun, but they're the most important. We are a team.
Well, it's important to have fun, too.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Which means we are a team, and then we have fun means we have fun.
That's who Millionaire Mind Kids are, and this is how we partner with Victor Valley Union High School District.
Terry Kurtz here, throwing out an invitation for you to catch up with High Desert Sports Activity, your High Desert Sports Report, showing three times every day, 7 and 11 every morning, 4 every afternoon. We see a somewhat different side of Joseph W. Brady in this segment of our April 11th interview, a segment I'll call Six Boxes.
So, Terry, this is really intended to be kind of fun. I'm going to have LJ, Latrice Johnson, who's our not only director of marketing, but she's our office manager, and Colleen Lugay, who works with us on social media, decide what they want to do about this. They may do nothing. We may put this on Facebook. We may not. I've been a registered Republican all my life. I voted my first vote at 18 years old, and I've never missed an election. And I like giving to certain candidates, okay? But let me tell you where I think the problem now has come. These six boxes right here weigh 106.4 pounds, okay? And when I say 106.4 pounds, it was May 1st of last year. We have our mail goes to a P.O. box, and we have it delivered every day. And I just would get a lot of political mail. So in the corner, you know, we had a box, and you just kind of throw it in the box, and the box got filled, and I decided to drop it off at my favorite congressman's office. I mean, I've only got one favorite congressman, and that's Jay Obernolte. And I took it down to his office for him to see the amount of mail that you get. So when we talk about the wastage of funds in Washington, okay, imagine the wastage of funds to try to get me to give more money. So in this box right here, this will give you an idea. This box is full, okay? And every one of these boxes is full. And what's ironic about it is I don't know why I was saving it. So we went through the election last year. And what I find is if you give whatever you give to one person, they must share all these lists. So it tends to multiply, and I think it's crazy. So at the end of the day, between May 1st of last year, and this is April 11th of this year, I have received 106.4 pounds of political garbage that I haven't even opened. So these are things I haven't even opened, okay? So... if people wonder, I mean, I'm going to tell you, we have some great political people. We have a lot of great elected people in this country that have given of their life, and they have the means to do it. But I'm going to tell you, you give them a dollar one time, and then they hammer you. And I'm really convinced that they share the list. So we are actually moving our office. We're moving sometime in May. So this gives me a great opportunity to free up six boxes for the move. I'm going to send this to Jay Obernolte. I'm going to send it to Senator Wilk, my favorite state as a senator in California. I'm going to send it to my good friend Assemblyman Tom Lackey, and I'm going to send it to Assemblyman Juan Carrillo. Now, while Juan is a Democratic representative, he is still an assemblyman that represents our area, and I don't think it has anything to do whether he's Democrat or Republican or Libertarian. I think that he cares a lot about his area, cares a lot about the part of our area he's got. So I want to share this with him, and then we'll post this video, and I don't know where it's going to go. But so back in August of 2022, in closed session, a gentleman by the name of Dakota Higgins stood up and told the San Bernardino County GOP that Joe Brady doesn't support the GOP. Okay, so Dakota, we are not done with that, and we are going to be sure that someday that the, because Dakota, we now have everybody's contact information, their mailing address, their emails on. So I'll probably end up sending this, but what I want to say to you and Shannon, and also to Phil Cothran, we do support the Republican cause. Okay, I don't like somebody speaking for me in closed session and saying I don't support the Republican cause. I don't know how much money that you've given the GOP in this county. I don't know how much money you've given nationally, but I think, Dakota, when you say things like that, every time now when I've gotten this mail, I really think about you. So this will give you an idea that, yeah, I wouldn't be getting this kind of mail if we weren't writing the checks. So I think the next time that you say something in closed session, you should think about it, because that's going to follow you forever. This video is forever. I'm going to send to Shannon. I know that she doesn't want to get any emails from me, but that's okay. But I think that sometimes when people shoot their mouths off and they don't know what they're doing, they should be careful about what they're going to find. So I won't say how much I've given. I'm proud of what we give. If you can, you give, and you so everybody, you know, these elections are pretty expensive. So with that, I just thought I'd make kind of fun of it and call it a day. So thanks, Terry.
The latest series of Operation Consequences raids netted 7 more arrests by investigators with the Sheriff's Gangs Narcotics Division, Specialized Enforcement Division, and personnel from the California Highway Patrol, San Bernardino County Probation, and the Department of Homeland Security. These latest felony arrests bring to 49 the total number of apprehensions made since the operation was launched in February. The latest raids focused dragnets in Victorville, Apple Valley, Hellendale, San Bernardino, and Ontario. Investigators also seized 9 firearms and 5 pounds of illegal narcotics. Operation Consequences concentrates on curbing violent crime, disrupting and dismantling targeted criminal street gangs, and locating and arresting criminals who are illegally possessing, manufacturing, and trafficking firearms. Consequences also involves crime suppression operations and parole and probation checks. There are currently 6,869 parolees at large in California. 456 of these parolees at large are in San Bernardino County. Terry Kurtz Online was brought to you by Down Home Grill in Victorville on the corner of Bear Valley Road and Ridgecrest Road.
Go, 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 go!
Bid fast and last. World-class auctioneers. Volu quality truck body. Family-owned and operated since 1954. The Bradco Companies, our area's longest-standing full-service commercial brokerage firm. Ewan Zach Law Firm, trial lawyers for serious problems. We got them, tees. Your headquarters for custom screen printing and mastercraft embroidery design. Silverwood, the developers of the Silverwood Master Planned Community, support the events, youth activities, and programs of our High Desert, Mojave River Valley communities. And by the Holiday Inn in Victorville. The Holiday Inn, conference and convention center for the High Desert, and destination of choice of visitors and travelers to the Victor Valley. That's a wrap on this edition of Terry Kurtz Online. On behalf of Victor Valley Television Productions, thank you for watching. We hope to see you again next time around.